Hey everybody. Hello, hello, hello. I can't believe it's third. Is it Thursday? It's Thursday, and I haven't been on all week. So I am sorry I have missed y'all. I hope that you liked the show. So, all right. So I wanted to come on, but I figured if I'm gonna come on, I might as well ask you if there's something you want me to talk about, because I could just talk about some stuff. So, okay. So this was the question. I'm gonna read it to you, and then we're gonna talk about it a little bit. Now, before I There's so many different aspects to this question that I could go into. There's just so many different layers of what I could go into. So I'm going to try to give as much as I can that will kind of give an overview. Okay, so here's the question. You want to know how to keep down scarcity and lack while remaining frugal and resourceful. I'm moving to Hawaii in 20 days. I'm jealous. Moving to Hawaii in 20 days, and I'm terrified of the high cost of living, right? It's expensive in Hawaii. My old fears and restrictions, so that's one word that I want to talk about. Restrictions are quickly moving back in. I learned to love that I am resourceful and frugal and find good deals. I typically make a game of it, but that old have to feeling is coming along. Okay. So, first of all, anytime you're feeling this scarcity and lack, what that is that is your mind. And I know you're like, yeah, Betsy, it's my mind. I can't control my mind. But here's the situation. It is not your, this week on the show, we talked about your inner knower, right? And your mind. Your mind is just designed to scan for fear. So it's just designed to look for shit that could go wrong, right? Does this seem wrong? Does this seem wrong? Does this seem wrong? Like your mind is supposed to be doing that. So one of the things that you said in here was old fears and restrictions. So when you're a teenager or when you're a little kid, what do you do when you get restrictions put on you? And this is for money. This, like when you all of a sudden decide you need to have a budget, this is for if you're going to diet. When you have a restriction, who usually put restrictions on you? Would be your parents, right? So it would be, your mom or your dad, or when you're a teenager, what did you do when you had a restriction? You rebelled. So that's your natural path. That's everybody's sort of natural path when they have a restriction is to push against it, right? So think about it. Even now with relationships, if somebody is, if you feel a resistance, right? You push against it, right? I don't know. My stream quality has been automatically lowered. Okay, well, I hope you're still getting me. So you're pushing against it. So this is all fear in your mind that's creating this lack or scarcity. The truth of every ancient book you would read is that abundance is everywhere. So if the truth is that there is abundance everywhere and you don't feel the abundance, you're moving towards scarcity and lack, it means it's not true. It means it's in your mind. It also means that if you are putting yourself there because you're trying to restrict, you're going to be pushing up against it. What happens when you push up against something? It stays, right? What you focus on is what grows. It's what gets bigger. Really, what you need to do, and this is going to sound, just hear me out, because you're going to go, yeah, right, like, because I get it, okay? I get it. But what you really need to do is get certainty. And what you need to get certainty is really faith, right? You don't have to have a lot of faith. You can have the faith of a mustard seed, as we have heard in the ancient books, right? So you can have just a little bit of faith. But if every time you get scarcity and lack feeling, which is your mind moving you, if you go back to that tiny seed of faith, that will take you out of the mindset of scarcity and lack. So that tiny moment and that tiny thing of faith is just simply a state of being. So not a state of mind, a state of being. So when I'm moving to Hawaii, when you need a visitor, let me know. When you're moving to Hawaii and you're like, I am so afraid because I don't want to, it's expensive. Like that's truth in my world. It's expensive. It costs way more. It costs way more to live in Hawaii than it does in Atlanta, right? Where I am. So I don't live in Hawaii, one of the reasons. So expensive. And every time I talk about going and moving to California, people go, "Oh, it's really expensive, Betsy." I go, "Don't put your doubt on me because I have the faith. I only need one tiny bit of faith that as soon as they say that, I go, that's not true. This is true. I know this is true. Abundance is what's true. So this all whole thing is an illusion. Now, I know that that's really easy for me to say because you're like, that's not super tangible, helpful. But when you have persistence, because all things that you're trying to change and outgrow, grow from, is just simply persistence, right? So if I can constantly be moving myself back to the truth that everything is abundant, there's faith. I just have to have a tiny bit of faith. The certainty, I don't care what you say or what I see, I have certainty. Here's the break. So when you have a belief, right? So I have this belief that it's expensive and that's going to be hard and I'm scared and it's scarcity. Then what happens is I have an action that's attached to that. Okay. So the biggest thing that I do with all my clients is break that action, belief, action, result, right? So when it's like a circle. So when I have a belief, it creates my action, which gives me results, which creates my belief, right? And it is a circle. So when I'm in that scarcity mindset, it changes my actions, which changes my outcome and then supports the belief that I had. So although this sounds like way easier said by me than done, it truly is. In the beginning, I wasn't getting very many clients and it really sucked because I had something to share, but I knew I could do it. But if I kept looking at my results and that formed my belief, I would have been like, I don't get results. I mean, there was a point where it'd been a couple months, and my husband's like, I don't know if this is working. I'm like, no, it's going to work. I'm not going to listen to you. So it was a breaking of the belief to the results. I'm not even looking at my results. I'm just focusing on my belief, my belief, my belief, my belief, my belief. So again, it's a mindset. It is certainty. It is that the world is abundant. That's what I'm focused on. And stopping the resistance. So when you resist, it's like when you're a teenager and you're going to push against it. It's just like, if I decide I'm gonna really watch my food. I mean, the first thing I do is be like, where's their chocolate chips in the house? Right? Like, I didn't even want chocolate chips before, but because I think I'm restricted and there is a resistance to that, right? Like my teenage rebellion thing comes out. So being able to detach. So detaching from the outcome, being really faithful, knowing it's coming, and detaching from it. Okay, so I want to talk about detaching from it, because what does that mean? And I know this is sort of a lot. There's actually a process that I would move my coaching clients through, but I want to kind of give you the philosophy of it, right? So if I am not resisting, right? If I am detaching from it, then I go, you know what? I'm trying to think of something I want that I don't have. Yeah, well, I don't want to go to the beach, right? So I want to go to the beach. So I have this feeling. I don't know if that's a good one because it's not really scarcity. Let's just say I want to make somebody give me one because I can't even think it. Is that bad that I'm so focused on the abundance I don't even notice? Let's go back to that time when I started my coaching business, right? I could have focused on how I wasn't making money and I wasn't finding my people and I wasn't growing. It wasn't doing all these things, right? I could have really focused on that. But when I detach, then I go, oh, I'm having that feeling of lack. That's interesting. I'm not going to push it away because I'm not going to resist it. I'm going to be like, that is interesting. So what does that, how long does that last? Where is that in my body? What is it trying to tell me? Is it making me remember something from my past? What does that story mean? Is that story true? So I get where I'm not resisting. I'm actually welcoming it in. And I'm going like, I want to really understand this at a higher level. So when we talk about scarcity and lack, we can still be frugal and resourceful because being resourceful is a wonderful state of being, right? Being frugal can be a fun state of being. You can be really frugal. You know who's super frugal is, I'm gonna forget his name now. Warren Buffett. Thank you. Warren Buffett, super frugal. That guy won't like doesn't like to spend money. He goes to the McDonald's drive-thru every day and gets one Egg McMuffin and a cup of coffee in his car that's like from 1982. That guy's super rich, totally abundant, but he is frugal. So don't confuse scarcity and lack with being frugal and resourceful, right? You can be frugal and resourceful and be abundant, and you can be certain, and you can be excited, and you can be focused, and you can have belief, and you can detach and still be frugal and resourceful. So I hope that that helped. I know that was a lot of information, but I hope it helped kind of shift the way you're experiencing scarcity and lack, because it is truly not reality. It's truly just what you're thinking. And I know that it can feel overwhelming. It can feel real, right? It feels very real. It's real in your mind. It's just fear, though.